thundering down the highways and byways of rural America without any consideration for the casual road users, these are the Big Mother Truckers. Here's your chance to let your inner redneck have his or her say. Choose your character and take control of your 18-wheel rig, trucking from city to city, wheeling and dealing and upping the stakes as you battle to build up a personal fortune. Arrayed against you are local biker gangs, corrupt sheriffs, and even your own redneck siblings who are out to amass their own fortune, even if it's at your expense. Oh, and watch out for the police as well. They don't take kindly to speeding juggernauts mowing down the Sunday drivers. Yes, it's time for another annual Madden update. And Madden NFL 2003 is just the thing for all you hardcore American football fans. Yes, both of you. If you have a deep understanding of the sport, then you'll find this latest update to be packed full of everything you could ever want, including 7 different play modes with a 30-season franchise mode, a new commentary, and the chance to create your own players, teams, and playbooks. And the management system is complex enough to make even the most tactical soccer manager whimper. On the other hand, if you don't know the game, then prepare to be baffled. Fortunately, EA has taken sympathy on those who missed out on the American upbringing, including an easy mode that helps you choose plays, assists with your filed actions, and turns off penalties and the clock so that you can pause the game and take as long as you need to decide what you're going to do next. They think of everything.
Number 31, we'll return this one.
It's time to go all-terrain once more with ATV Quad Power Racing 2. There are 17 massive tracks occupying 5 different environments around the globe. So pick your hero from 10 of the world's top professional riders and prepare to get dirty as you physically battle with your opponents to the finish line. The over-the-top controls and game physics allow you to pull huge air and amazingly impressive power slides. And with more than 20 freestyle tricks to let you express your wild side while tearing up the competition, there's no chance of a boring ride. Add to that a bundle of multiplayer modes, and we're in for some real 4x4 fun. Ninja Assault isn't exactly what you'd expect from a title using the Ninja label. Where we'd expect stealthy killings and escaping like a ghost into the night, we get blasting things with the biggest gun you can find. That isn't to say it's not fun, though. While this light gun arcade action game may be a port from the arcades, there has been some thought put into the conversion for home users. Granted, arcade mode is a direct port, but you can find a heavily modified game in the main story mode. Here you can find more characters, cutscenes, and even multiple endings. There are 9 levels in total, along with jiu-jitsu mode and plenty of mini-games to keep things interesting. The plot sees the evil Shogun Kigai kidnapping the Princess Koto and her trusty ninja bodyguards. You'd better get her back or you won't get paid at the end of the month. Besides the heroic Gurren and Gunjo from the arcades, you now also get the chance to play a female character, Aoi, who comes with her own backstory and alternate ending. And despite not being able to see the characters on screen, your choice of hero does affect your constitution, attack power, ammo capacity, rapid fire ability, and health, so choose wisely. If you want to see some awesome water effects and tricking that would make Tony Hawk blush, then Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer is the game for you. interaction with the wave is more realistic than we've seen in any previous surfing game. And the whole experience is extremely fast and marvelously fluid. You can ride down the curl of a wave, duck your head into it, actually break through the curling lip, and enter into the barrel forcefully. You can shred, rail, and slide all over the surface, with fakies and grinds all the way. The whole wave is interactive, so you can create, combo, and gyrate like never before. Kelly Slater's Pro Surfer has more impressive stunts than any skating game, along with spectacular water effects and a great sensation of speed. It's definitely time to get wet and wild. Legaia 2 Dual Saga is a Japanese turn-based RPG and the sequel to the PS1 hit, Legend of Legaia, released 3 years ago. The story begins when the tyrant Avalon steals the magical water crystal from the desert village of Nol. The village soon becomes shrouded in an evil light, and powerful monsters start roaming the land. Upset by this, a young member of the militia named Lang sets out to recover the crystal. That's where you come in. Features to watch out for include the unique battle system called Tactical Arts, where you can enter a series of directional button inputs to call up a special attack combo or maneuver. Each character also has access to their own origin, an elemental force that can assist in battle, solve puzzles, or heal party members. You can also combine different items to create more powerful weapons and tools, as well as taking part in the many mini-games available. Will it prove to be as fun as its predecessor? Let's hope so. Wave the Samurai is an action-packed sword-fighting adventure from Acquire, the original developer of the Tenchu series. Set in feudal Japan, you play a wandering samurai who gets drawn into a conflict between two warring factions. As you progress into the immersive storyline, you'll hear both sides of the story, and every decision you make will influence the outcome of the conflict. The sword-fighting aspect of the game starts you with just the basics of fighting, but as you progress, you'll be able to collect up to 40 new swords, each representing a new fighting style and featuring their own unique attacks, making 200 different attacks in total. And combat isn't just hack and slash. Timing, blocking, and balance all play equal roles in the art of the swordsmaster. As an extra incentive, progression through the game unlocks various features, including a head-to-head fighting mode for one or two players and a series of characters and weapons to use there. As if you needed any more reason to hack people up with a katana.